All right, we're all ready to film.
Where is everybody?
That's a good question.
Here we go again.
Boy, the way Glenn Miller played.
Songs that made my hit.
Guys like me, we had it made. Those were the days.
Hey there, MHS, and welcome to this week's edition of The Friday Show. I'm Jalen Moffitt, and it is hard to believe we are already halfway through October. The best part, though, is we are a week away from fall break and then Halloween. Speaking of Halloween, if you're partial to making your goodies versus buying them, then you'll enjoy this first segment.
Hey guys, it's your girl, Jay Vieira, and today I will be making Halloween cake pops.
The first thing I'm going to do is preheat the oven to 350. Then I'm going to get all of my supplies. The supplies that you need for this is 3 eggs, veggie oil, water, baking spray, cake mix, some sticks, and little bags. My first step into making the cake pops is cutting the bag of cake mix and pouring it into a bowl. Next, I'm going to crack the eggs and pour them into a bowl along with the cake mix. My third step is pouring 1 cup of water and 1/3 of oil into the bowl.
Now I'm gonna set this for it to mix over there. And this is what it looks like when it's done mixing. Nice and chocolatey. Okay, so now I'm finna get my handy dandy pan. I'm gonna pour this into here and I'm gonna stick it in the oven. So.
Before I pour the mix into the pan, I'm going to spray the pan with baking spray. Now I am going to pour the mix into the pan and move the cake around into the pan so it can be even.
Okay, so our oven is ready now and it's ready to go in. And you have to stick it on for about 15 minutes. And until the 15 minutes is over. Okay, so now I'm finna take the cake out of the oven. And we're back, and I got the finished product. It's full, nice and juicy, period. And we got the little candy melts and the icing to make the cake pop come together, a plate, got all of this good stuff, and I got a special guest, the one and only cake lady, my mother.
I called on my mother to help me make the cake pops. She takes some of the frosting, crumbles up the cake, and maneuvers her hands into the cake. you're going to roll it up into a ball. It should look like this. Next, my mother is pouring the candy melts into a jar so she can melt them for a minute. She takes out the candy melts to stir them and put it back in for 30 seconds. After you mix it and it looks creamy, you grab your sticks, dip them in the candy melts, and stick them inside of the cake pop. It should look like this. Then you're going to stick the cake pops into the refrigerator for 5 to 10 minutes so that they can stay in place. Here are the steps into designing them. First, you have to dip the cake pop into the candy melt as the first coat. As you're dipping it, you have to make sure you don't put too much on the cake pop. So dab the stick softly on the side and shake it to smooth it out. You have to let the cake pop set for 10 minutes. Lastly, you make the eyes, which are two black dots. And then you do the mummy wrap. And all you're basically doing is drizzling the white candy melts back and forth. It should look like this. And these are the finishing products. As you see, my mother's cake pop looked way better than mine. I called on my little brothers to test out my cake pops, and this is their reaction.
One, two, three. Good.
You said it's terrible.
I said it's good.
What do you rate these cake pops out of 1 to 10?
5 star.
A 5? What do you rate these cake pops?
10 stars.
You like them?
Like a 5 star restaurant.
Oh, okay. So it's a 10. So we got 2 10s. So... until next time, JVera is out.
As I mentioned, Halloween is still a couple weeks away, but it's never too early to hear a scary story, especially if it takes place here at MHS.
You guys might not believe me, but one day after school, I was editing, you know, for the Friday show. And I went to the bathroom. And I could have sworn no one was here because it was just me. It was like way later after school. It was like 6 o'clock. And the only person who was in here, Mr. Harbaugh, I promised to God, I thought he was the only person in here. So when I went into the bathroom, you know, I was doing my editing thing. And I started hearing a girl humming. She was like laughing and singing. She was like, I just kept hearing that. So I thought I was tweaking. I'm like, okay, maybe I'm not the only person in the bathroom. So I'm minding my business, and then I went to go use the bathroom. And I went in the first stall, and wasn't nobody in there. But I kept hearing the humming. Looked at the second stall, nobody in there, but I kept hearing the humming. And I just looked at every saw and I just kept hearing this weird demonic humming. It just kept getting louder and louder. And it was nobody in the bathroom. And then once I had checked all the saws, the toilets just all started flushing at the same time. And I just ran out the bathroom, left everything in there, did not look back. And I tried to go tell Mr. Harbaugh, but he was like, that didn't happen and it was just all a lie. So I just went home and I never told anybody, but.
So one day of my eighth grade year, my swim team members decided we were gonna go to the high school to condition with the swim team. And we had a friend named Mary. Mary was already on the swim team because she was in high school, so we went to go work with her. Before that though, we had asked if anybody wanted to get food, and Mary said no. So she stayed back, we went to go grab food, and when we came back, she was 12 feet under. Now to this day, every time we go to the swim pool, all we hear is laughing, the bubbler sounds in the drowning pool. We hear the strokes because she was working on strokes. And then it's just like that.
So I was rehearsing after school for the fall play, and I heard this ruckus, like it was almost a scream, I think. And I thought I heard something drop, but maybe I didn't, you know. So I continued to rehearse my lines, and then I hear another scream. But I was on the stage by myself. I'm looking around like, what is going on? At this point, I'm scared, I'm nervous. Like, I couldn't believe what I just heard. So I ignore it at first. I continue to go over my lines, and then I hear it again.
So I had heard this story about some students, and one day it was winter time. I think it was Christmas Eve, and for some reason there was lightning. And these three students, they were running around the track trying to get faster, trying to get stronger, you know. And the field house, it was struck by lightning. And from what I've heard, is those three people are stuck there still today, and they just have to continuously run until their souls are free.
I have heard that before.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
You remember that one time when you, me, and China were running?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was so weird because it was wintertime. And
dude, all these pieces are being put together.
I know.
Because the last time we were running, I looked, like, you could hear somebody screaming the sound of
footsteps
running.
Yeah.
But we turned back and there's nothing there.
I wonder if China knows about this.
You're right. She was running with us that day.
And, like, that was completely, I saw that.
But wait a minute. Where's China?
Where is China?
Whoa.
Oh my gosh. We have to go find her.
Bro, there's no
Where's
way,
China?
No,
we're now just realizing that she ain't here.
Where's she at? Yeah.
There's no way she's not here. Wait, wasn't she just here?
Wasn't she with y'all?
Yeah, I thought so. Because that
she has to be out there.
Like, she can only be at the field house. She was with you guys last.
Right.
So maybe we should go there.
Maybe you should go to the field house and find her.
While the NFL is almost halfway into their season, the start of the NBA regular season is just around the corner. Based on all the off-season moves, many are anticipating many competitive games, especially between the two teams located in Los Angeles.
With the NBA upcoming season on the horizon, fans are looking forward to a more balanced league than ever before with the breakup of the super team known as the Warriors. Now many NBA teams are looking to make a run for the championship and fulfill their championship aspirations. On the heels of their fifth straight finals appearance, the Golden State Warriors have not only lost a big name superstar like Kevin Durant, they've also had to deal with the injury to another key piece in Klay Thompson. With the season on the brink, MHS weighs on what the future holds for this once powerful super team.
I think the Warriors, the Warriors will be a top five team in the league because Steph Curry, Draymond, and D'Lo. But without Klay Thompson, they won't be a championship contender team just due to his defense.
Oh, yeah, Warriors suck. I mean, KD leaving. KD messed with Freddie Gibbs. KD leaving. Warriors suck. Klay hurt. Steph, you know, he going to make a couple threes and all that. But Warriors, they ain't coming with nothing this year.
Warriors. Come on, that horrible. D'Angelo Russell, that's my man. Horrible. Stephen Curry. Horrible. Klay Thompson. Injured. Who else? They ain't got nobody. They better off having me. Give me a jersey. Steve Kerr, give me a jersey.
I think the Warriors are going to do well this season because they have the best player, Stephen Curry, on the team, and you know he's the best one. So already they're going to be the best. You already know.
Yes. They won't win the championship this year, but they still got the best shooter to ever live in Stephen Curry, so they still get to the playoffs. They'll be out by the semifinals of the Western Conference.
Meanwhile, in California, two LA teams look to make their mark on the new NBA season.
Then let me see about the Clippers. They gonna win it. They got Kawhi, PG, Lou Williams, sixth man of the year, 5 years in a row.
I'm the real NBA expert, and I believe the Los Angeles Clippers, they've been pretty good this year. Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, they decent, but they ain't got nothing on LeBron James and Anthony Davis. So the Clippers will be good. You know, Doc Rivers, good coach, all that, good roster, but they ain't got nothing on King James.
They got a chance to win. It all depend on if Anthony Davis stay healthy. You know, he fragile. And really, they need to probably just pick me up because I'm the best point guard in the country, but it's up to them, you know.
The Clippers, I think they'll be number one seed in the West this year. Even though LeBron will come with it and play hard and get his team to the number two seed or top five seed, but I think the Clippers will be the NBA champions this year, honestly. And Kawhi Leonard will win three championships with three different teams and become the best player in the league.
With new competitors ready to take over, with now the West and the East now up for grabs, is anybody's ball game as to who will win this year's NBA title?
Gonna win it because they got the best two defensive small forwards in the league. Can't nobody really match up with them for real. And they got Patrick Beverly, he a lockup. He locked down, so you know, I feel like they gonna win.
Hey, you know LeBron gonna go off. You know LeBron probably gonna drop 32 a game. AD gonna drop 26. So that's game right there.
Nobody know about the Nuggets though. Nuggets really cold out here, bro. They got Jokic, Jamal Murray. They got hella people, bro. Niggas will come out the West, and they're going to beat Toronto in seven. Something slight, man. They don't know.
This year's champion, without a doubt, is going to be the Los Angeles Lakers. I think they're going to sweep the Bucks in the championship, or maybe Boston. I don't know. Probably Boston. They probably sweep Boston in the championship. But the Clippers, they weak. Warriors, they weak. Lakers coming out the West. King James all day. Shout out to Bronny and Zaire.
With the more balanced lead, these teams have upgraded their rosters with tremendous free agent signings and offseason moves. Which one of these teams will be a champion in June? Only time will tell. Signing off from PNN, I'm Kadarian Johnson.
My friend China and I were thinking about lunch the other day and how much we enjoy chicken nuggets. That led to a debate about which fast food restaurant has the best chicken nuggets. While we won't reveal the answer until next week, here is a little preview of the taste test.
Maryville, do you like chicken nuggets? Well, make sure you tune into my segment on next week's Friday show where we decide which restaurant has the best chicken nuggets.
The competitors are Burger King, McDonald's, and last but not least, Wendy's, who will come out on top. Find out next week on the PNN Friday Show. Signing off from PNN, I'm the fabulous China Royster.
The MHS boys soccer season ended last Saturday in the sectional final. Despite the loss to Chesterton, the team has many fond memories to look back as it was one of their most successful seasons in years.
This year, the boys' soccer team shocked many. For the first time since 2014, we were ranked in the top 10 in the area. And for the second time in school history, we won the Hoosier Cup. Many of the soccer team members reflect upon a successful season.
Starting in the beginning of the season, I knew we had a lot of potential with the players that were coming back and what I had seen in the improvement from my sophomore season to my junior season. So coming in, we had a good attitude. A lot of guys worked really hard in the summer, so I think that's really what led us to our success in the beginning of the season. We gelled really well together. We kept improving going into the middle of the season until we played the Hoosier Cup, and that's kind of was one of the highlights of the year. We won the Hoosier Cup, only being the second team of Maryville to do that. So that was a really good experience. We played really well. It was like three games in 24 hours, so it was rough, but it was worth it. Coming to the sectional, our first sectional game, we won that pretty convincingly 4-0. Going into the next one, a few days later against Valpo, which we also won, so that was good. So we had a tough opponent Saturday in the sectional final game, and we gave what we had. There wasn't really much I'd say we could have done better. It's just that we played a tough opponent and we did all that we could. Overall, as a season, I would say, well, I know it's the most successful since I've been here, but I'd say it's one of the best.
My outlook on the season as a whole, I'm proud of it. We had a lot of accomplishments that me, Nico, Jacob, and Austin set goals to hit, and I'm proud that we hit a bunch of those this year.
As a whole, the season, it was pretty great. You know, winning 11 games last year, we were 7-8. Now this year, we're 11-8.
The year this year actually went really good. It was the best year we've had in 4 years. We won 11 games. It all started with the hard work that was put in the off season, in the summer, those tournaments we went to, the camp. We did win the Hoosier Cup this year, which we're only the second team in school history to win it. And we did get to a sectional championship game, but we lost to Chesterton, but they're the number three team in the state.
We did have some setbacks near the end of the season. We had a number of injuries to several key players, and that caused us to lose our last four regular season games. At the time, we were a little distraught going into sectionals, but after getting a couple players back, I really have to hand it to our players for stepping up and showing a lot of character in winning our first two sectional games. Both were shutouts, 4-0 in our first game against Portage, and a huge game, a 1-0 victory over Valparaiso. That enabled us to get to the sectional final. This year, I really thought with seven teams in our sectional and having to win two games against two very difficult DAC teams, I really thought these guys earned a sectional final appearance and therefore should really be proud of themselves. While we fell a little short against Chesterton, considering that team has been undefeated for the last 2 years here, especially if they go on to win back-to-back state titles, I think these guys can look back and be extremely proud and not have any shame in losing the sectional final.
One of the many goals achieved this year was winning the Hoosier Cup.
Being the second team to win the Hoosier Cup is pretty amazing. You know, following up the team that won it is pretty great. And also setting the benchmark for the guys below us and also leaving a legacy.
The four captains have huge plans after high school and many hope to continue athletics in college.
So for me, I'm looking to play college soccer. As of where, I'm not sure right now. I'm going to a few identification camps this fall and then into the winter. That's what I really want to do. I want to get my major in accounting, and then after that, we'll see.
My plans after this high school season is go to school for business and also play soccer collegiately.
Plans after high school, I'm hoping to run track. Maybe if a coach talks to me about playing soccer, I'll play soccer. And then just going to college regardless. If I do athletics or not, that's up to college.
Plans after high school is to play collegiate soccer. There's a whole bunch of schools that I'm looking at. And I want to major in radio and television, which is the main thing. It's always about getting your education first, sports second. And then hopefully if it's a smaller school, end up also playing football, which is also a goal of mine to play soccer and football in college.
Many of the senior captains in Coach Past have some quotes to remember for the younger guys.
My quote for the classes below us is, always be yourself and don't let people change your perspective on things.
What are you willing to give up to be on top? Leave everything on the field. Play every game like it's your last game, because high school sports goes by fast. I mean, it was one of those, and the season was already over and we were in sectionals.
Pick your head up. It's never gonna end. Well, yeah, it's gonna end soon, but like, you got time. Work with what you got. Develop as a whole. Don't just develop as yourself. Like, some people like try to get good by themselves, like work as a team. By the end of like your senior year, it's like, say if y'all like us, by your senior year, y'all work as a gel, y'all gonna be straight. Y'all got it for next year.
I would say that to enjoy every moment, because it really goes fast, and that the good times will always outweigh the rough ones in terms of losses or anything like that.
Our senior class this year, 11 guys that we had, which is a lot. They all had their important role. I believe 8 of them started, which were huge.
Overall, not only am I proud of the 4 senior captains who you've seen throughout this segment, but especially all 11 seniors that played this year. They have definitely left a legacy for our younger players, and it's a little ironic that for a soccer team, you need 11 players on the field. And these 11 seniors, I believe, have really earned the right to look back on their high school soccer career and be extremely proud of everything that they have achieved. The wins were impressive, but I think the character they showed even in the losses is something that will help them and enable them to be successful in life.
Even though we didn't achieve the main goal of a sectional championship, this season was one for the books, and hopefully class of 2021 can keep the ship rolling. Signing off from PNN, I am the one and only Miko Jukic.
Congrats to the boys soccer team on their season, and best of luck to the football team tonight and the cross country teams at their regional tomorrow. Thanks for joining us today, and tune in next week to the special Thursday edition of the Friday Show, right before fall break. Signing off for PNN, I'm Jalen Moffitt. Have a great weekend, MHS.
Don't want to interrupt the mojo, Fast. Jalen just did the first segment without messing up.
Right. Oh my gosh, right. Mr. Harbaugh, right, don't jinx me. But it's never too early to hear a scary score. Yikes!
I thought
we were going to
be perfect.
Mr. Harbaugh, really? No, don't do, no. No bloopers. All right, at
here
all.
We go.